Alrighty then, what's up guys? Over Raze Game here. Welcome back with another live stream for you guys. So what's up and welcome back with another one as always for you guys. Daily live streams, if not videos for you guys. So welcome back with another one. And Detroit Lions, of course, season one with no loss. Now I'm gonna demonstrate this for you guys because NFL 18 fucking screwed me the fuck over, and it fucking pisses me off because my season is 11-1, and well, obviously you know the last game I won. I have not lost a single fucking game. You can go check game 11, or is it game 12? No, it's game 11. Yeah, I clearly won. You told me finish the game. You told me exit that shit. And for some fucking reason, it's telling me to play the same goddamn team again. And I'm just like, what the frick? I already played this team already. Why is it making me want to play the goddamn team again? Like, what the fuck? So stupid me for taking the risk, you know, of advancing to the next week and not going through with the team, you know, and playing it myself like I did the freaking first time. I mean, I was already pissed, like I said, that I had to play the same team again already, since I already fucking know that I played it once already. And it even says I played it once, so I don't fucking get why. It really irritates me, it really does. So nonetheless, I said I should have just took the, you know, I should have just went with it and played, because I know I would have made a hell of a lot better decisions for me to win, and two, they probably wouldn't have scored as many points as they did anyway. So fucking stupid, really is. So nonetheless, they ended up winning 44-38. But here's the thing: I don't consider that as a win, only because I already fucking played them. That's the thing. I already played him once. I played him the very first time, and that's the legit time. The second time is bullshit. Alright, I don't even consider that as even there. So I'm ignoring the season as of right now. I'm ignoring it because I don't give a fuck. Alright? Because I consider that bullshit. I played the goddamn, I mean, the evidence is there on the stream, which is on my channel. The evidence is permanent there, and boom. Set and play. It's there. Watch the whole goddamn game. That's the game right there. Then and there. So, I am 12-0, not 11-1. I just ignore that one because that is bullshit. I don't give a fuck about that. Because, like I said. So, I've never lost a game ever. Still in this season. I don't, like I said, I'm ignoring that entire game because I do not consider that. That's fucking bullshit. Alright. Sure, I definitely should have played them, I know. But I didn't want to sit there and play a whole hour of a game when I'm sitting here trying to do the next stream for you guys, if you get what I'm meaning. Plus, like I said, it was a 50-50 chance, so it, whatever. It could have went either way, but whatever. Nonetheless, I shouldn't have had to play the same damn team again anyway, because I already played the fucking team. So, with that out of the way. So like I said, I am still 12-0. I'm ignoring the goddamn season numbers right there. Frick that shit. I'm ignoring it completely. And now when I back out, I'm going to 100% make sure that that shit is there first before I leave. Because that's going to piss me off if I come back and that shit ain't there. You know, I'm not going to be taking that risk no more. If there's a team that it's going to make me fucking replay again, then fine. I don't give two fricks. I'm going to replay it again because I don't want to take that chance of ruining my season shit. And like I said, I'm ignoring the 11-1. I'm ignoring that shit completely because that is just bullshit. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm sure you guys agree. Obviously, if you guys saw the last game, you obviously know what happened. That's what happened. Legitimately, that's what happened. This next one, bullshit. It really is. Because I already played them once, and that should have been Boom. Yeah, that should have been the set right there. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoy. Smash the like button if you guys do enjoy it. Smash the subscribe button if you guys know my channel. It'd be greatly appreciated as always. On the road to 400, you guys are freaking awesome. Thank you guys so much for the love and support. It means so much to me. You guys have been so awesome with that. And I really do appreciate it a lot. Don't forget a shout out to Delta Outlaw. Link for his YouTube channel in the description below. I'll be doing that for him for a couple little bit here until he reaches 300 at least. I'm hoping helping him out. Thank you, new subscribers, for subscribing to the channel. We are now at 270. That is insane. Welcome to the Overrates Army. You guys are freaking awesome. Don't forget to follow me on my social medias and Twitch. Links will be in the description below. As always, this will probably be the only stream because I do have work the next morning and I would like to get some sleep. I am a pretty tired person as of right this minute. But, nonetheless, I should be able to have a couple streams for you guys for the rest of the weekend, so do stay tuned for those. Nowhere in Wolverine, Incredible Batman, or none of those guys, because I am working the entire weekend. I was going to have Incredible Batman join me tonight, but unfortunately that kind of flip-flopped because of situations with him and not being in the best condition that he is in. So, maybe next Saturday or Friday or something, I don't know. But nonetheless, let's just get right into it. So like I said, you know, ignoring the last game. Because we don't give a frick, and that is just bullshit. So, let's rock and roll. Like I said, I do not count the last game. Nonetheless, my season is a perfect season anyway, so whatever. I just think that game was a fucking bullshit.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and you're tuned in to Madden 18 on EA Sports. In today's game, passing may come at a cost. The Bucks are number one in forcing interceptions, and they'll be up against a Lions team that will need to avoid those turnovers.
All right, thank you, Larry. We are on the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucks were introduced a moment ago. And they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Detroit Lions. Three quarters of the NFL season are complete. What lurks in our final month? We're underway in week 14. And this will be a touchback as Ed sails over the end line.
Yes, come on.
So here are the Lions now coming out for their opening drive. They'll be led out by a former Pro Bowl quarterback out of the University of Georgia, Matthew Stafford.
Such a key cog in their AFC title win 2 weeks ago. Remember what he told us this past week? That he couldn't wait to get out here to this day, to this stage, but also was trying to take it all in as well, trying to slow down the process a little bit so he wouldn't be overamped for the game.
Yeah, he said, I want to slow it down but speed it up all at once. Now the game is here and he's ready to shine. And he whips that one incomplete there. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, his intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
Oh, let's do this shit yet again.
To throw again. Stafford.
Oh, you fucking
and this
idiot.
This is incomplete. Golden Tate, his intended receiver. And it's third down. And a quick look at the Buccaneer defensive starters.
But Gerald. entered the NFL, he was part of a huge debate around the league. Gerald McCoy or Ndamukong Suh? Who would be the better defensive tackle? They both had more than their share of moments. And what's made Gerald McCoy a perennial Pro Bowl player? His ability to play just about anywhere on the defensive line, but especially to work over the centers and guards in order to create havoc in the pocket.
Throwing on third down, Stafford. It's complete to Golden Tate. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number one.
They are going to go for it. It's Stafford. And Tate's got it. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
Oh, yeah,
now
let's get it.
Completion, we're going to get
let's get it.
While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
It was worth it. You're okay, my homie. You will live. At least hope, anyway.
On first down, it's Stafford. Finds a seam inside the 40. He's got his Jared Abradaris. Touchdown, Detroit. Jared Abradaris. His ninth touchdown of the season. And the Lions are going to take a first quarter lead.
After.
It's up, it's good, and the Lions lead 7-0. That time, 75-yard drive, 5 plays, and the end result, a Detroit touchdown. Martin the punter now out to kick it away. This one taken from the 7. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Now the first carry for Doug Martin. He takes this for 3 to the 29. Here's the offense, and highlighted is a guy who gave himself his own nickname, the Dugginator.
Brandon, you really can't nickname yourself, but if he keeps running at this level, he'll have plenty of good nicknames to choose from.
All right, here we
7 yards to go on second down. Working out of the gun, Winston. But he's got the hook up here to DeSean Jackson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Bastard.
That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now, or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
On second down, Martin. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at 6.
Well, now they're in a spot that every team tells us when we have our production meetings they don't want to be in, third and long. And that's because those back-to-back running plays just didn't accomplish a whole lot.
On third down, Winston. Yes. The Lions pressure, he's brought down. Ezekiel Ansah in there to get him, and that's sack number 12 for him on the year. Partner, we had their game last week where they had 6 sacks, so a little bit more momentum here again in the first quarter.
And last week it appeared that they were coming out of sprinter's blocks chasing the quarterback. So how do they continue that? How do they keep making it happen? Different looks, different disguises, different angles that they chase him.
They were so disruptive last week. We'll see what the trend is here as we go forward. Now the 6-year man from Cal, Brian Anger, on to kick as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. The Lions offense heading out as we give you a look at the playoff race coming into the weekend in the NFC. As of this moment, as pretty much everyone knows, they sit alone in that top spot, but nothing is guaranteed. They haven't even clinched the playoffs. So a good start, but a long way to go.
And you know, a blunt veteran inside their locker room has stood up at one point or another and said, You know, all this means nothing so far. We've got to cover this, get it done. What do we want to be? It's like winning a title in August, right, in preseason. Doesn't count. Let's go ahead and get this thing done. Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through 2-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
So the offense lining up first and 10.
Fine, I'll run. I'll run. But only this one, though.
Now the Notre Dame man, this is Theo Riddick. And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back, right at the line of scrimmage. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Hey. They go back to Riddick. Powerful running.
Oh, damn it.
Lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. That's a loss of 8 yards there to bring up third.
For me, that was an example of why offensive linemen might want rearview mirrors at times, because you have your assignments to block, but if you could see what's going on in the backfield, that maybe the guy carrying the ball is headed in another direction, it might change what you do up front. But if they can't see that, and he's not in sync with what they're doing up front, well, this is when you end up with plays like this. A bad one for the offense, a really good one for the defense.
And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted.
What?
A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down.
You a-holes.
So possession one ended in 6. How is that incomplete? Possession two likely going to end in a punt.
Yeah, that's okay. They just got to get back to what they worked on in the opening drive and continue to make a few adjustments along the way. It won't be exact because the defense will make a few adjustments themselves. Just get back to your game plan.
Go frick yourself.
This offense converted once already in this first quarter. They're going to try it again here on fourth down.
Yeah.
So they will go for it. Stafford. He'll rifle this right side.
Pricks.
And they will not be able to hook up there. It's
and you could suck your dick.
Boy, a real head scratcher there. And that will force a turnover on downs. And partner, I'm not really sure what in the world they were thinking on fourth and long there at this stage in the game, but you think social media may be firing up a little bit right now.
Oh, the coach is trending right now. All right, there's no doubt about it. People are wondering what that decision
is. Oh, it'll be intercepted. It's the 2014 NFL interception leader, Glover Quinn.
Glover Quinn came into the NFL as a cornerback, but he's morphed into one of the better safeties in the league, and he just finished this one off with that nice pick.
Suckers. You just got smoked.
The Lions offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On first and 10, Stafford. The completion good. This is Eric Ebron. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
Well, some mistakes were made, but also came back with the interception, so I'm not going to complain at that point. Like I said, I hope you guys do enjoy.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
I hate running so much.
Turned into a pretty nice little gain.
I'll give it a try. It didn't work the one time, though, so I don't know about that. I'm pretty skeptical.
Spins by.
Oh!
And now running right
through.
And he works free. Theo Riddick. Touchdown, Detroit. Theo Riddick. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Lions add on to their lead. A first update now from Cleveland. Early lead in that one for the Packers. Aaron Rodgers leading the charge offensively. Now Prater to add the PAT. And it's good to make it 14-0. Martin the punter now out to kick it away. This one taken from the 7. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
Get him.
Shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Throwing the out route and complete.
That's Jackson. What the fuck?
It's a big play there for the Buccaneers. 45 yards.
Throw it long, it can be a big play. You throw it short, it can be a big play for DeSean Jackson. Yards after catch, always a big part of his game.
Talking about speed, only Tyreek Hill was measured with a faster play last year than DeSean Jackson, who hit 22.6 miles per hour on a touchdown versus the Cardinals in week 13.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Bucs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter, and they've got it here with a first down.
Four down.
Check back 40.
Winston with a give to Martin. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
Again, it's Martin. And he's going to bring this one down to right about the 20-yard line. 8 yards there on the carry, and now they're left with a much more manageable third and three.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
Third and short yardage, Winston.
Woo-hoo!
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Tahir Whitehead in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack.
That's insane.
Here's Nick Folk now on for the field goal. This one from 46 yards out.
Oh, I could have blocked it.
And this one is right down the middle.
Oh,
and they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3.
Oh, my God, are you...
So three drives now for the...
Are you kidding me? Did you see my fucking player?
This offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
Yeah, as an offensive coordinator, if you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong line of work. But in his defense, this has been a stifling defense so far. So they've got to start finding a way to unlock them as this game goes on.
Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Coming up later tonight, a reminder, one of the best rivalries going. We'll have the Ravens and Steelers for you at 8:30 Eastern. And then tomorrow on Monday night, another divisional matchup. This time it's the Pats heading down to Miami to take on the Dolphins.
Nice twofer there.
On first down, Stafford here.
Oh, you bitch.
Pressure gets to him and brings him down.
Beat your
Stafford
ass.
Is sacked. Noah Spence in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
So I don't fucking run, you dumbass coach.
A shifty move, got him a couple extra on the play.
No more goddamn
running. That run,
running.
Good for 6 yards, but they're still looking up at
anywhere.
A third and 15.
That's right.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Third and long, it's Stafford. And he'll find Galladay.
Go.
20.
Yes.
10. Touchdown, Detroit. A big play there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Lions are able to grow their lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Prater on to add the extra point. And it's 21-3. Scoring summary, 3-play drive. And it's capped off by a touchdown for the Lions. Martin the punter now out to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Jameis Winston and company heading back onto the field now. He's got to dig deep here, doesn't he? Team's losing. He's not playing well either.
And they always tell you, don't press, you'll make things a little bit worse. But in this particular situation, you try and heighten your play a little bit. So far, he's thrown one interception. He wants to balance that off with at least one touchdown pass in order to get his team back moving forward.
They start the drive with Martin, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. They run it again with Martin. And he'll get about 3 here as he's out to the 30.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Winston from the gun on third down. And this is going to be incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They've looked lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
He gets this one away. And boy, it's
another
boomer.
That's what I'm saying. That's why I should have deserved to fucking win that last game.
This is taken at the 23.
The reason why, you bastards, because the Lions
yards
are freaking good.
And the Lions will take over.
Who's my Lions
an NFL
anyway?
Update, second quarter now in Jacksonville. And the Jags, they're out to an early lead there. Blake Bortles leading the way offensively. They'll run it now out of the gun. Riddick light on his feet, and he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
On second down, here's Stafford. It's caught by Abradaris. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. When halftime rolls around in just a bit, we'll send you to Orlando. You will hear the dulcet tones of Mr. Larry Ridley with our EA Sports halftime report.
Does dulcet mean good?
Yeah, it's just something that broadcasters say. It's got to be good, right?
It's gotta be
you
good.
Tell me.
Well, it's got to be good if Larry's doing it.
Stafford on first down.
Ooh!
It's Abradaris. It's complete.
Yes.
And look out, a big hit to the shoulder pads took him right off his feet. And a nice gain of 21 yards. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Zone now, Stafford. And oh, this is taking him one-handed. What a catch. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
That was a terrific catch. I mean, to go up there and get it one-handed like that, but I almost want to go into that riff about back in my day, the gloves weren't quite like this.
When did gloves really become prevalent, just in general?
I think in the 80s. I think as we started to move through the 80s, especially as we got towards the latter part of that. But a lot of those were really like baseball batting gloves to begin with not much of a tacky area on the glove. In fact, there was none. I actually remember in cold weather games wearing the old scuba gloves, which you'd wear in the diving, but they would split too easily.
He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. Eric Ebron, his 9th touchdown of the season, and the Lions add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. The second quarter score from Cincinnati, and it's the Bears who are off to the early lead. Mitch Trubisky, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one. And they open the lead up now to 25 points.
Hey.
So that drive spanned 5 plays. And the end result, a Detroit touchdown. Martin, the punter, now out to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Mike Evans and the rest of the offensive unit heading back out there now. A chance maybe here for them to get him more involved. They're down here on the scoreboard, and he's been very quiet.
And the silence has been deafening for his team. They don't need that at all. They need fireworks. They need explosive plays. They need him touching the football in any way possible. Maybe go to some jet sweeps. Anything to get him going.
Yeah, something to get in the ball. We'll see if they can do it. Winston now to throw on first down. Gets it to the rookie from Penn State. It's Chris Godwin. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Now a second down throw for Winston. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Chris Godwin that time. And it's third and short.
One thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
Ready. Blue lady.
On third and one, here's Winston. And he finds a man. It's Martin. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. First down, Winston. It's caught by Mike Evans. That one goes for 24 yards. And that's the first connection. The number one overall pick at 2015, finding the number 7 pick at 2014 in Evans.
And what a great target Mike Evans is for Jameis Winston. Winston's a pretty accurate thrower, but that catch radius that Evans provides, that makes him that much more dangerous.
Throw right side, caught by O.J. Howard. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. He hit his first one, this from 44 yards out now.
Aw, damn it.
And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. Second quarter in Cleveland. Early lead in that one for the Packers. Aaron Rodgers with 2 first-half touchdown passes. So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
Fairly short kick, taking it to 14 here. Oh, another spin!
Hard to line him up when he does that.
And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this will go as a short gain on what will be the final act of this first half. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Lions taking the lead to the break. As we send you cross state to Orlando to check in with Larry Ridley, he's got our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Buccaneers trail at home at halftime. The Lions have looked good on the road and will just try to keep the ball rolling in the second half.
Oh, yeah.
All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Now first and 10, broken coverage here on the pass play, and he's going to go 51 yards for the score. Lions with the early advantage. First and 10, the pass ends up being picked off. Quinn's the one who makes the pick to give a boost to his defense. Offense out now following the INT. Reddick's going to take off here, and he'd go in for the 50-yard touchdown. That puts them on top by 14. Lions have it midway through the second. Pass coverage will break down here. And a quick three-play drive ends with a score. That takes the lead up to 18. Now to late in the first half. Here's Matthew Stafford connecting with Eric Ebron. And this four-play drive goes for a touchdown. That takes the lead up to 25. Staying late in the half. Evans is wide open, able to make the grab. And he'll make it out to the 34-yard line. They would go on to kick a field goal and put 3 points on the board. So that's it for us. We'll go back now to Tampa for the start of the second half.
All right, Larry, indeed a one-sided affair to this point as we get set for half two. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three.
I'll be right back. 1 sec. All right, sorry about that.
This one taken from the 7. And he'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. With the Bucs offense making their way back out on the field, let's take a look at the playoff picture, Charles, coming into the weekend in the NFC. And I tell you, 4 weeks still to go, and everything is wide open, and it's fun.
And I know we always talk about, well, if the playoffs were to begin today, and then we kind of go, okay, but they're not. Let's see how it plays out. Wouldn't it be fun to play with this playoff lineup right now? Because to me, just about anyone can win this whole thing out of this grouping we currently have.
And by the time we get there, it may look entirely different.
Ready. Blue ready. We've got four. Four down. Blitz out.
The third quarter starts with a run by Martin. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
Hitting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. And some options here for the offense on second and two. Jameis to throw it. He's got his tight end over the middle, O.J. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to.
More chill, that's down. Why.
Ready.
First down.
Yeah, get it.
And now loose football. Woo! Martin lost it, and the Lions have recovered. He's now lost fumbles in back-to-back weeks, and of course, you remember last week's game, such a close affair, that hurt him.
Hurt him in a big way, and it is so key to take care of the ball, because remember, the team making the fewest mistakes usually wins the game, so you got to take care of the ball, lock it away, high and tight, as you often hear from running back coaches. 4 points of pressure, fingertips, forearm, biceps, sternum, or chest, put it away.
And a great spot to start this drive from here. Following the fumble recovery, Stafford throwing deep for Gump, and that is caught.
Hey.
Touchdown, woo. Detroit.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well-organized, well-coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
Now Prater to add the PAT. And he's been a busy man for five now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Martin the punter now out to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 8. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So out come the Bucs now. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Well, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. He takes this from the 30 to the 34.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Check, tight right. Solo out there, check it out, ready, blue ready.
From the gun, Winston. This complete to Martin. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Ready. Keep it up, guys. Blue lady.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line hasn't done a great job of protecting him in this game. And there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside. Probably starting to get a little frustrated.
Got to keep his composure. Can't let the defense know that they're getting to him.
So second and 10 here. From the shotgun, it's Winston. And the Lions pressure too strong. Woo! Down he goes. Ziggy Ansah. In there to drop him, and his great season continues. 13 sacks for him now on the year.
Damn, that's fucking crazy. And he's about to throw, too.
Winston needing a big play after the sack as he leads the Bucks up on third and long.
This is insane.
Ready. Blue lady.
Working out of the gun, Winston. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. A gain of four on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down. Here's Brian Anger now, as he's on to punt for Tampa Bay. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. And now let's look at the quarterback, Matthew Stafford, in our player spotlight. And the deep ball has been his friend, Mr. Davis, and to the tune of the lead right now.
And isn't it fun to watch? I mean, I don't care which side you're for. I don't know who you're rooting for, but
don't be biased.
Listen, I'm trying my best to stay neutral, but that is a pretty play. It's similar to going to watching batting practice with a home run hitter, a big-time player, and you just see it happen time and again, and that's what we're seeing in this game.
He is rocking and rolling. So are they. Here on first down, he couldn't quite hold it, got hit, ball pops out, incomplete. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot, but they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
I'm just more chilled more than anything.
Now Riddick. What a spin. Oh, and now he bowls him over. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down.
I got 11. He's mine.
They'll fake it. Now Stafford steps away to his left. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield across the 45. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Oh.
to review the play. The ruling on the field is reversed.
What? I don't even...
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and ten.
Oh, what a waste.
Out of the gun, Stafford.
Oh!
The completion to Ritter. Still staying on his feet. Are you serious? It's a big play there for the Lions. 51 yards.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
What
and this
fuck
one's
are you doing?
Incomplete. Kenny Golladay, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. By the way, third quarter now in Cincinnati as we take a look at the NFL scoreboard. And the Bears have scored to add on to their lead in that one. Mitch Trubisky with one touchdown pass thus far. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Robert Ayers in there to get him. And that sack number six for him on the year. He didn't get rid of the football there, took the sack. Although that's easier said than done. He can't just chuck the thing sideways into the seats.
No, he really can't, because you're not afforded total protection as a quarterback. You have to get outside of the tackle boxes as defined by the NFL.
Yeah,
meaning
suck
wherever
it, bitch.
Your tackles operate normally, get outside of that. And the ball that you throw has to get back to at least the line of scrimmage. Otherwise, you face an intentional grounding call.
It only took Stafford 90 games to hit 25,000 yards in his career, fastest ever, and he adds to that yardage total there.
I'm not sure anyone in the league has a more confident arm than Matthew Stafford does.
Yeah.
He can wait until they're actually open before delivering, as opposed to anticipating them being open because of the strength of his arm, and he doesn't mind showing it off.
That's what she said.
From the gun, here's Stafford. Oh, and it's incomplete. That would have been big in the end zone if he could have held on. Instead, it's second down.
Not too many missteps in the red zone thus far. He was going for his fifth touchdown pass. His man couldn't shake free there, but boy, you know he's going to take another shot before this one's over.
Yeah, exactly, because you know three is good, four is excellent. You get five, that's a whale of a game. Now it's Stafford off the bootleg. Being chased out left. And that is caught, but he will come down out of bounds, says the side judge. Incomplete. He was trying to find Marvin Jones that time, and it's third and short.
All right, Captain, it's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodge two pass attempts to the end zone.
Looked like it was in, homie.
Well, knowing them and knowing what we've just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you've kind of run out of your running plays. Fire another one into the end zone.
He's got his
yes.
hand. It's Woo-hoo. Caught for a Lion touchdown. Eric Ebron, his 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And the Lions have got it on cruise control. Well, it was third and one. I was expecting runs, so much for that. They pass it, they score it.
That had the feel of the head coach telling the offensive coordinator, you've got four downs here. We're going to go for it on fourth down unless there's a disaster on third. Go ahead and take a shot if you want to. And he gratefully accepted the opportunity and did exactly that. If they didn't get it there, that had the feel that they would come back and try it on fourth down.
Yeah, no doubt. He's got me figured out, homies. Well, the nibbers got it figured out.
Martin the punter now out to kick it away. This one taken from the 7. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now the Buccaneer offense gets set to take over. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board.
Hey! Harris, he's taken down. Kerry Hyder in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And the guy looks like a dumbass.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now in Tampa. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Second down, Winston.
Hey!
It's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had 2 interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning.
Damn,
I mean, just
nuts.
Watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
Here's the Lion offense now as they get ready to take over. It's a quick turnaround for them after the turnover, but the way they moved it on their last drive, they're probably eager to get right back at it.
And you know me and you know my tendencies in this situation. What do I want right now?
Be aggressive.
Be aggressive. Take your shot right here.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit.
I'm just kind of taking my time because it's like, whatever.
On the ground, it's Riddick. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Blitz coming, and down he goes.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
After the sack, Stafford and the Lions come up on a third and long situation. A shotgun snap for Stafford. And Jones has it over the middle. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. 23 yards on the play. Well, I'm sure he likes his performance a little bit better fourth quarter, and he's got his guys in front.
Guaranteed he put in a tremendous amount of work this week. But maybe the matchup is just better for him. Sometimes it just doesn't work out. It's almost like those golfers. Certain courses fit their eye. And they like what they see. In other courses, as soon as they tee it up, they know they have no shot. Maybe that's the difference for him. Last week, no. This week, a big yes.
And a quick throw here. That's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie,
You enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game. Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Again, it's Stafford. Finding fouls complete. And he takes this one.
Yes.
Lions touchdown. Darren Fells. His second touchdown on the season. And the Lions just continue to pour it on. So another score there, and often you talk about the three phases of the game, defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching, and he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. Prater on to add the extra point. Now, this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Martin, the punter, now out to kick it away. On the return now, it's Josh Huff. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. With the Bucs offense making their way back out on the field, let's take a look at the playoff picture, Charles, coming into the weekend in the NFC. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Haloti Ngata. He's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
Now Jameis on second down. Evans has it left side. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
Ready. Watch for the pass.
On third down, Winston. He's got Evans. And he will have the first down as he gets this to the 47.
What's up, one viewer? Welcome to the
stream. The play goes for 19
yards. Dude, I'm pretty dead right now.
Gives him a new set of downs.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move.
Not gonna lie.
And able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
That's why I'm drinking this. I don't even know how many minutes we have left. Because I can't even see. I would think that we don't have many.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
What's tight? Tight end right. What's tight? Tight end right. Ready. Blue 80. Hey, four down.
Winston.
And oh!
Free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Almost intercepted that again.
Things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does
for that team
is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
They're on to the fourth quarter now, by the way, at Bank of America Stadium in Carolina. And not much trouble in that game for the Vikings. They've opened their lead further. Sam Bradford, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one.
Tight right. Ready.
Let's go. Throwing again, Winston on second and 10. He was trying to find DeSean Jackson that time, and that'll make it third down.
We always talk about receivers. If the ball hits your hand, you're supposed to haul it in, but it is hard to adjust to a pass thrown a little bit behind you.
That one was all the momentum going forward. Couldn't contort his body back to grab it. The Bucs on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 10.
Ready?
To the air again with Winston. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Evans. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really
all
for
right.
next week.
Like I said, bro, smash the like button. All that good stuff. Subscribe. Turn on notifications. You know how it is.
Well, they don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Ready. Ready.
First down, Winston. Time for a break.
Oh,
he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On second down, Winston again. Over the middle, he finds Godwin complete. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Here's Winston. His throw caught at about the 5.
Yes.
And he's
Let's
able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you...
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I will hear about that.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Ezekiel Ansah in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. 6 sacks given up in this one.
Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's third down.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Third and goal, Winston. And that one's going to be over everybody in the back of the end zone. It's incomplete.
What a job by this defense all game long. They've come together and really said, no one's crossing our goal line, and they're definitely not going to start right now.
You can just see the dejection. Feel like nothing is working offensively. They are in the 4th in Buffalo, and emerging victorious, the Colts. Andrew Luck, a touchdown pass to help lead the way. So they get 3. They were hoping for 6, an unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board, happy, but you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have 6 on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up 3 after letting them run that much offense.
And Detroit getting set to go now. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out. But for the most part, They're not as worried and concerned about getting him out of the game, and that's always puzzled me a little bit. Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Lions, the win moves them to 12-1 now on the year. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Chicago Bears. Meanwhile, for the Buccaneers, they drop their seventh game on the year. And they'll be at home for one next week as the Atlanta Falcons come to town. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say so long from Tampa.
Alrighty then, I hope you guys did enjoy. Smash that like button if you guys did enjoy. Smash the subscribe button if you guys know my channel, be part of the Orpheus Army. You know, freaking awesome. I love it if you're one of you guys. It means a lot. Smash the notification button so you guys don't miss future uploads like this in the future. As always, I'm going to make sure my shit is there because otherwise I'm going to lose it otherwise. So, beauty. Awesome. Alrighty then. So like I said, hope you guys enjoyed. Social medias and Twitch are linked in the description below so you guys can stay up to date on all good information and whether or not I go live or not on my Twitch channel. But nonetheless, that's basically it. I'll see you bros tomorrow and tomorrow's awesome lit ass streams. So stick around for those coming up. As always, over his gamer, signing out. Stay awesome, bros. Perfect.